Next week is MyPillow CEO Mike Lindell's Cyber Symposium. And that is supposed to be the time where, over the course of about 3 days, he is going to lay bare all of the information he has to prove that somehow China interfered and changed the results of the 2020 election. This is all a total farce. There's no actual evidence. This didn't actually happen. He is lying. Now that we've got that out of the way, let's not forget that for months and months, Mike Lindell has been telling us that Trump is going to be reinstated on August 13th after his cyber symposium, and he takes all that evidence to the Supreme Court, and the Supreme Court, he has said, is going to rule 9-0 that Trump's the legitimate president. Boom, Trump's back in office, right? Well, about a week or two ago, he said, now hold up, folks. May not be exactly on August 13th, you know, it may be within a few days, maybe. Well, then Monday of this week, he did an interview with the Daily Beast and he said, whoa, it may happen in September or maybe even sometime way after. I don't know. So he keeps kicking the can down the road so that he can keep stringing along his idiotic followers who, by the way, are starting to get super pissed with him for doing it this way. Here's what he said to the Daily Beast. We'll be bringing our findings to the Supreme Court in late August or early September, sometime after the cyber symposium ends and it proves it was an attack by China. When I gave my prediction about August, and that was several months ago, that was an estimate at the time, but it took so long to get this symposium set up, however long it takes for the Supreme Court to take it up and decide on this, I can't predict that. I'm not the Supreme Court. So he's basically telling everybody, like, whoa, hey, I don't know what the hell I'm doing. Because for the record, the United States Supreme Court is not even in session. During the time of his cyber symposium, I believe they're out for all of August. So yeah, that's not a thing that could have even happened. And people had been pointing that out for months and months and months when he said they were going to rule unanimously on this when they weren't even going to be in session. But again, what he's doing here is he's just buying himself some time, okay? That's all this is. He knows he's a fraud. He knows this is a farce. I have to assume he knows these things. But he also understands that he has a whole gaggle of followers who are, you know, not quite right. And they are getting pissed, according to reports. They're starting to look at him and say, wait a minute, maybe this isn't the kind of prophet that we thought was going to come along and fix this whole election thing. So now they're doubting him, which probably isn't going to bode well for his little idiotic cyber symposium. By the way, in a recent interview, not the Daily Beast one, but a different one, Lindell said that they have the routers, which they actually don't have, but they've got the packet captures from the routers. And those packet captures prove that there was outside interference on those routers from the information they got from the routers. And IT experts were quick to point out that's not a thing. That's not a thing that exists. You can't get a packet capture from a router because a router is just some signals, basically. It doesn't store any data. So he's lying about that, like a bald-faced lie about getting information, packet captures, as he calls them, from these routers. That's not a thing. And of course, as we reported a week or so ago, he unveiled his evidence, which was a blurry string of numbers and letters sprawled across multiple different screens that you can't make any sense of. The guy's lying. He's lying through his face. And now he's trying to kick the can down the road because deep down he knows nothing he's predicted is going to come true. And eventually, everyone, even his most ardent supporters right now, are going to realize he's a total fraud.